And welcome back to Ireland AM. Now, still to come on the show. Oh, before I tell you about that, I got a text. I'm getting acting lessons from Simon and everything. Now, what could this be? Aidan, as a huge tank of a man, we think it's only right that you should be the one to represent Ireland AM on the rugby pitch. Your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to take on Greg O'Shea, Ireland's Rugby Sevens International, and bona fide fine thing. Hashtag scrum buddies. Hashtag it is what it is. Hashtag don't forget your sun cream. Here's how I got on. Bring me up.
To say this man had an eventful summer is an understatement. Greg O'Shea, the winner of Love Island, has invited us here to the IRFU High Performance Centre to chat and maybe learn a few skills. Greg, how are you?
Good, man. Yourself, how are you?
I'm very well, thanks. Congratulations. I know it's 4 months ago now, but I'm sure people are still going, well done, you did it for Ireland, you did it for us.
Is it 4 months at this stage? It could be, yeah. It was madness, man, the summer. Unexpected. Never thought it would ever happen. Mm. I loved it.
Well, people have found out since that you're a professional rugby player, but you decided to skip off for a few weeks into the villa in Love Island. What was that all about?
Yeah, so they got on to me in February about doing interviews and stuff, and I did it for a bit of a crack, and whatever. I kept getting through the rounds and through the rounds. I was like, okay, there's something going on here. And I told the boss man and what was going on, and he goes, look, if it doesn't affect rugby, you can go ahead and do it. So initially I said no for going in at the start, and it worked out I could go in at the end of the season. Popped in for 2 weeks, ended up winning it, and that's it. History now.
Yeah. Were there moments when you're in there where you just went, what am I doing in here?
Oh, so many times. Sometimes I just sit down and be like, what is going on? I'll be always thinking what the boys are thinking as well. At home, be like, oh, they're going to rinse me when I get out. And they did, rightly so. They put manners on me very quick here.
I bet, yeah.
Yeah, of course.
So it didn't work out between you and Amber, but
no.
All is okay?
All is good, yeah. We always kind of knew, and people forget this, that behind closed doors, me and Amber were always chatting, being like, look, we live in different countries, like, and we're always having that conversation, and we were saying, look, we'll see what it's like when we get out. And we managed to see each other once in the space of 5 to 6 weeks. And I was like, look, being realistic, how is this gonna work?
Mm. Yeah. Do you have any regrets when you look back at it for doing it?
Any regrets? If I had to say I regret something, would be the fact that My grandmother passed away while I was in there, so I didn't see her in her last couple of days, which is kind of unfortunate, but she was so sick and she just passed away unfortunately when I was in there, but ITV were great and they let me leave and come back, and that was the only thing really, but otherwise I loved it, yeah.
I'm sure there's plenty of people, men and women, who watched you on the show, loved you and went, I fancy a go at that. And there's a new series around the corner. What advice do you have for people who want to be on the next series of Love Island?
Yeah, so there's a new one now, a winter special. I'm not sure how it's going to go. It's on in Cape Town. It sounds really cliche, but literally just be yourself. Like, and that's the reason you're going to get in there and you've been asked to go in is because who you are as a person. So don't try and force it. Don't try and be something else, because the public are so smart and they'll pick you off straight away if you're being someone you're not. It is aligned in certain ways that they tell you to have certain conversations at certain times, but they're trying to make a TV show. But everything you hear and everything you see is everyone's own autonomy, their own words. So that's what I love about it, that you are getting the real person.
Okay, final couple of questions on Love Island, because a lot of people in the office want to know the gossip. It's not me, Greg. They want to know, are Maura and Curtis for real?
I think so, yeah. Obviously, it's just my own opinion, but I saw them together and, like, they are mad about each other. She's really into him and he's just such a nice guy, and he always kind of had his eye on her, even though he had certain different things going on in the villa at the time. But I think they're going great and they seem to be doing really well over in London.
And I've been asked to ask you, Greg.
Yeah.
Are you single?
I am single, yes, I am, for the moment.
I can't believe I'm asking you this. I want to get on and talk about rugby, but anyway, are you single?
I am single, yeah. Kind of doing me, myself and I at the moment. The big focus is getting to the Olympics, and I just don't really have time for anyone at the moment. That's not saying I'm closed off to it. If a right woman comes along and it works, but at the moment it's just me.
Okay, the DMs are open.
Yeah.
Okay, but you mentioned rugby, and there is so many dimensions to you. People will go, oh, that's the guy who won Love Island. But before that, like you say, you were practicing law, studying law, and you're a professional rugby player. Ireland Rugby Sevens, big tournament coming up, actually, by the time this is on TV. You could be mid-game. Yeah. Tell us, firstly, about Rugby Sevens, apart from the obvious numerical difference from 15 to 7.
Yeah.
What's different about Rugby Sevens?
Yeah, so as you say in a tin, it's seven aside, so it's faster and it's 14-minute games. But we've been building up for 3 months now for our first time in the World Series, the first time Irish Sevens is on the World Series. The women have been on it already for a couple of seasons, so they're kind of paving the way for us. We're following in behind them. So hopefully now we can represent the country well.
Okay, now next year is a huge year for sport around the globe and in Ireland, 2020. Yeah. You know, the Olympics is coming.
Yes.
Will we be there?
Well, fingers crossed we'll be there. We have one more chance to get there now, last chance saloon called the Olympic Repassage next June on in France, I believe. It's the last 12 teams in the world that haven't qualified just yet, and the winner of that tournament goes to the Olympics. So you have to get it all right in one weekend, which is tough, but that's sport. So we're really looking forward to it. But that's at the end of the season, so the 10 legs we have in the World Series building up into that should get us ready for it. And hopefully now we can join the Irish women hockey team and everyone else and get there.
Indeed. So winning Love Island has opened up a lot of opportunities for you. Breakfast radio you did. You were brilliant, by the way.
Oh, thank you, sir.
May I say, as a fellow radio breakfast host.
That's it.
One of the other things you've got to do, and I know it's close to your heart, is represent the Alzheimer's Society of Ireland. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so when I got out, I wanted to work with Alzheimer's a lot because, as I said, my grandmother passed away while I was in the villa, and she suffered really bad from dementia. She had a stroke as well, but like I just saw how much dementia can really affect people, and that's obviously a part of Alzheimer's. So I couldn't get quick enough in to help with them, and I was just involved in their memory ribbon campaign, and was there on Thursday the 21st of November, and we collected, got loads of money, which is great. Thanks everyone for donating, and I'm going to stay with them as an ambassador and try and just help them, because there's something like 55,000 people living in Ireland with dementia or a form of Alzheimer's, and there's just no help for them, like, so I'm trying to do my bit.
Well, well done you.
Thank you.
If I may say so. Good luck in Dubai. Seeing as we're here, would you teach me a few skills?
Yeah, let's do it, man.
What are you laughing at?
I don't know, have you played rugby before?
Do I look like I played rugby?
You look fit enough to me, man, to be fair.
Well, I don't look like I could play rugby in this, so let me get changed. I'll be back in a sec.
Okay.
Right then. That's better, isn't it?
That's more like it. Let's get going.
Is it yours?
Okay, embarrassing now if you've got
just received the pass. Score try in the dying moment of the match. Right. 1v1. Everybody, you know I'm going to go that way. Yeah.
I wind it. Yeah. Nice, Silla. Yeah.
Not bad.
Good power. Best of luck. Oh, that's pretty good, man.
First time luck.
Very good. Well done. That's me.
Yeah. Greg, thanks so much for having us here today. It's been cool to meet you, catch up. Good luck in Dubai.
Thank you.
And good luck with the qualification for the Olympics next year as well.
Cheers, appreciate that, man.
Final question, are we going to see any more reality TV?
Is there
one you haven't done? Jungle?
Maybe down the line I can get into the jungle, but for now it's Olympics.
Credit where credit is due. That was very impressive.
Oh, I like that. We're going to talk about me and not Greg O'Shea.
Well, we'll talk about
my
both
drop
of you.
Goal.
But yeah, that was very good. I'm impressed.
Beginner's luck.
How many takes?
That was the first one.
Was it?
Yeah, don't be so surprised.
This is the sarcasm.
I make a little mini prop. Oh, anyway, good guy.
Are you besties?
Bezos.
Bromance?
Bromance, yeah. Hashtag scrum buddies. He's a great guy.
He seems really nice, really genuine.
I'd never met him before, but he's very at ease with himself and very easy to chat to. No bother answering any questions. Not that was grilling or anything
relaxed,
like that.
I mean, you were asking him, was he single? Yeah. A lot of people wouldn't be keen on answering that question.
Yeah, nice guy. And he's got a lot going on, and particularly, you know, with the rugby sevens. That's huge now that Ireland are competing at that level. They're in Dubai this weekend.
Yeah.
They'll move on to Hong Kong, I think, in a week or two. So, yeah, he's a lot going on, but he has the career behind him as well as dabbling with the reality
TV. Of
course, yeah. Olympian this
clever
summer,
lad.
Sure.
And then the Olympics next year is a huge goal for them. Fair so, smart lad. Yeah,
but he's
very
a smart
likeable.
Lad in that he's taken every opportunity that has come his way since he came out of the Love Island
absolutely.
House, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Well, I think he's
done the 2FM radio show.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen him in so many different places or different guises. So.
I think he's been clever though as well to remember what it is that he does. And at the moment that's rugby.
That's
so
the bread and
he
butter.
Could have been opening every nightclub in the UK for months and months and making a lot of money, but he's chose to focus on his sport.
And that's a full-time job for them, is it?
It is, yeah.
In the sevens, okay.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, to become an Olympian, like, is, you know. That's huge.
Mm.
You know.
So he's got his head screwed on, we had a lot of fun.
We like Greg. Yeah. Okay.
And we like Greg.
We like Greg. You're in, Greg. You're
up,
in
Greg.
The fold. I'm sure you were very concerned. We're talking about job interviews and nightmare situations, and there's a huge amount of texts in. Mm. Mary says, my daughter went for an open interview with an airline about 6 or 7 years ago, so we're getting closer now, aren't we, in terms of time?
Yeah.
And the group were asked if they had any tattoos. She put her hand up and said she had a small one on her foot, and anyone who had one were eliminated immediately. Isn't that mad?
That's, well, as somebody who
Aiden,
has
you
tattoos,
wouldn't stand a chance.
I'd be gone, wouldn't
You'd
I?
Be yeah. gone.
You got a little sneaker, one of them there.
Out the gap.
Mm-hmm.
This one is bizarre, Pat. I was interviewing a 22, 23-year-old student for an internship. He not only showed up with his mother, but also wanted to be accompanied by her during the interview.
That's a wind-up.
That has to be a wind-up.
Not according
22
to Pat.
Or 23.
Wow. Wanted his mum there.
This is my mummy, and can she come into the interview as well?
That'd be us now in 15 years.
I'll go with you, love. I'll go in
just to make sure.
Just to make sure.
Do you see Rachel's? I once went to an interview, was asked what my weakness was. I said, ooh, it'd have to be chocolate. Certainly broke the ice. You can just see he's a deadpan.
Yeah, good honour.
It's a good answer.
It is.
Because it is one of those questions that gets asked in interviews, you know, what are your strengths and then what are your weaknesses? And you're like, well, what do you say?
I'm a perfectionist.
I'm tardy, you know, I like chocolate.
Yeah.
Perfectionist always comes up.
Always comes up. It's the easiest one to throw out there, isn't it? Yeah, exactly.